Thanks for that.
You have a good one.
Still.
Well, I turned the camera on. I thought I saw some of the guys coming around here. Getting ready to pull in the lot, but I guess I blew it. We'll let it run at this point, though. It's 10 after 1. I've been here since about 11:30. So, hoping somebody shows soon. Somebody with a camera on their head. Hey, how you doing?
You here for the meetup?
Oh yeah, for the barbecue and the raising hell.
Oh. My name's Adrian.
Adrian? Bill, how you doing?
Good, how are you? Bill?
I'm Bill Chicago.
Oh, very cool.
YouTube.
What's Jesus your animal? Freak.
Pardon?
Jesus freak.
I think he's gonna do that. And then I'll just leave with him from the barbecue. So I got this back in April and I had some sort of, and it's multiple problems, but it's kind of like a shuddering, like it's running rich or starving for something. So, my father-in-law used to be a Honda mechanic, and I went up there and said, I'm going on this ride, and it's just kind of freaking me out. So he and I were looking at it, a couple other things I had him work on. Pulled the air cleaner out, and it was a stinking mouse nest inside the air box.
And a what?
A mouse nest. It was stuffed full of stuff. Mostly food, though. It didn't look like they actually lived in there. It just looks like they stored stuff in there. But it sat for 5 years.
Good lord.
The guy sold it. But
of course, you weren't videoing that, right?
No. Yeah, it runs a little better now.
No, I can imagine.
A month and a half before that. And I was so excited just to get on something and ride. It could have been snowing, and I probably would have ridden it home.
I bought a brand new 1973 Honda CB750.
Yeah.
And I bought the damn thing in February in Chicago.
Oh, really?
And I had to actually drive through snow drifts to get it off out of the back door.
Oh, really?
Place.
Of the dealership?
Oh, yeah.
Wow.
And the first day I had it, I put 500 miles on it. And I had one of these old snorkel jackets that you've seen with a helmet on and snowmobile gloves and stuff. Couldn't have kept me off of it.
Yeah. And had it been a while before you...
No, actually, I had sold one the summer before.
Oh, okay. But you were off of it, it sounds like, for a good 8 months or so, huh?
Yeah, but that's normal for the winters in Chicago.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah, one of these guys is Vader. Yeah, the one in the black helmet, that should be Vader. You know, you can always recognize it with those stupid cameras stuck to the helmets.
Of course.
Howdy.
Hey. I know the guy at the far end there is going to be Vader.
That's right.
Bill Fish, Big Bill Chicago.
Hi, Big.
I'm Adrian.
Hi, Adrian.
Jesus.
Hey,
Bill, how you doing, sir?
Good. How you doing?
Real good. Bob? I'm Peter.
Okay. Bill?
Adrian. Hey, Adrian, how you doing, sir?
Nice to meet you. Nice to meet you too, bud.
You have a good ride up?
Oh, yeah. But I done it yesterday.
Oh, you did?
When I got off work, and I said to hell with it.
And left.
And so I left Chicago around 3 o'clock yesterday afternoon, and got here around 9:30. Stayed at Motel 6 across the road there.
Okay.
Got lucky there, got the last
room.
Long
drive for you today.
Oh, well, I've got it on video here that, all right, I'm pulling out of the motel and I'm going to the meetup point. I've been sitting out here since 11:30 this morning.
No way, really?
Yeah.
Anybody else show up yet? Or?
I was going to give up when he finally showed up, so.
Yeah, you think he was at the wrong place.
Yeah, it was a joke.
Well, on the video, Terry said, meet up at 2 o'clock.
Well, that's actually when we were going to leave here. Was 2 o'clock to go over
to
the park.
Yeah, because he said it's 2:30 or something.
And originally, I shared one that was going to be at 12:30 with the start meeting up, and 1:30 we were going to pull out.
Yeah. Yeah, there was some flip-flop. I was commenting on this. I don't know if there was an official time or not.
Yeah.
You know, it's
well, Bravo, Charlie, and...
just be here.
The mayor and Bravo, Charlie this morning were trying to get in touch with me. I didn't have my cell phone on, but when I logged on the computer, I got a note there from Bravo Charlie that, hey, we're trying to get in touch with you. How about going for breakfast? I'm at the Hampton. Well, I thought this was the Hampton. I was thinking, what? You're right across from me?
Yeah.
So then I called him and he says, well, yeah, we went down here to Andy's. I saw that name. I said, you're a newcomer. Yeah. He said, we're looking for you. I said, I'm in North Canton.
Yeah.
I said, how in the hell are we going to get together for breakfast? You know.
Unless you're almost here.
Yeah, I'm not exactly across the street from you here.
Yeah, not exactly that door.
When I texted Chuck, Suburban Rider, when I was leaving, he said we're about 30 minutes behind the meeting. So.
What, that was coming up here?
So.
Well, if they got that maniac MT8 leading them, God knows.
Is he here?
He'll be here in a minute.
Is he going to be all make it, or?
Well, I know he showed up in
Zoo Dog Jay, Bravo Charlie, and NP8 all were at Newcomers Town yesterday.
Oh, wow. Okay.
So they pulled in there yesterday, so.
Okay. Cool.
Well, with him.
He was afraid with that, all that stuff he had on the back.
He actually had 2 spare tires. That
I was looking at the unit.
A bunch of bikes coming up. A whole bunch of
them. We got some guys, ALR Rips. And some of them might be coming in from Virginia. That went straight to Newcomers Town and supposedly got there yesterday.
Ah, okay.
So.
Oh, right there.
Yeah, I think they missed it. Unless there's a...